now that she's back in Siargao, it's been quite uneventful, quite boring, quite quiet actually. But I've also been busy. Like I said, I just finished my first lock-in taping. So, because whenever Ellie's in Siargao, I get the time to, I get a lot of me time. Ellie was actually with me prior to the first lock-in, so she eventually got stuck with me for, I'm not sure, about 3 months. Yeah, she wasn't able to fly back to Siargao, so, you know, it was my first time to spend that much time with her consecutively. So, it was one of the best days of my life, actually, that I got to see her, got to be with her every day for that long. It was actually quite tough because considering her age, you know, kids her age kasi, but they always look for activities, new things to do every day. So I actually was challenged to come up with things to do and stuff to watch. But yeah, it was fun. I think she learned a lot of new things. I taught her how to play badminton, various board games. I tried to make her damay with all my, you know, with all my interests like Michael Jackson, the Beatles, basketball, but to no avail. I failed spectacularly. Actually, right now, she's very much into fashion. Fashion and, what do you call this? Graphic designing? I enrolled her into online classes. I became a dad at the age of 21. Mm-hmm. You know, so I had barely made it out of my teen years. So admittedly, back then I was still, you know, quite self-centered and my only worry was where to get my next drink, parang ganun. So when I found out that I was already a dad, you know, my life took a 180 degree turn for the better. You know, I had a soul to take care of, to nurture. And I guess the biggest lesson was, in my case, was to man up, to be responsible. I guess my only regret, because I was still in the middle of finishing my studies abroad. So I was based abroad in Singapore. So I guess my only regret would be I missed a lot of milestones. Like, I couldn't be there when she was born or when she learned to walk, her first day of school. Yeah, I guess those are my biggest regrets until today. I guess it would be, because prior to the lockdown, we had only started to travel together. We were able to go to Singapore and Hong Kong and many local destinations like Rojas and Dumaguete. And she turned out, you know, liking, you know, traveling and, you know, the outdoors. And she's very curious when it comes to traveling. Co-parenting with Andy, it's been smooth these days, which is great. But, you know, it wasn't always this easy. You know, there are many ups and downs, a lot of faces. But, you know, I guess it's because we were, you know, we became parents at such a young age. So, you know, we were both immature. And, you know. But, you know, once we realized that we had to prioritize Ellie's well-being, we had to be, you know, Ellie-focused, and that we had to be a team for her, you know, everything since then has been smooth sailing. I mean, of course, there will always be disagreements, but you have to be, you know, you have to, prioritize your child and, you know, always learn how to compromise. Well, to defend myself, I mean, I guess there's no one right way in raising a child, right? Like I said, like being a girl dad, you can't help it, but, you know, worry for your daughter. But I guess I'm more authoritative than an authoritarian, if that makes sense. Parang I want Ellie to trust and respect me rather than fear me. I want her to be open about everything. I want to be her best friend. And that's how our relationship is like so far. It's hard to pinpoint just one, but I guess, yeah, given the relatively small age gap between us, you know, we're very open to each other. She shares with me, you know, everything, and, you know, I just don't want her to be distant, you know, because I guess that was my experience with my parents. So parang I want us to be like barkada lang. Probably empathy towards others. And ever since the pandemic, resilience. Because it's been really tough. I mean, you know, we spend so much time away from each other. We don't see each other for sometimes more than a month. And, you know, because I love watching the news. So every morning I watch the news and, you know, she's next to me and she sees all of these, you know, negative things. But I always, make it a point to remind her to, you know, that you can never expect what life throws at you. It will always be unfair. What's important is how you deal with things. This is during the start of the first wave or the first lockdown. That was the time when our frontliners were having a hard time in acquiring, you know, the PPEs. And so my batchmates in Saver School, back in high school, we did a fundraiser so we could help procure PPEs for our frontliners. And I involved Ellie in, you know, packing and sending the boxes of PPEs to different hospitals and medical establishments. I guess that's where, you know, me trying to instill the value of empathy towards others, because I went to Savior and we were, you know, taught to be men for others. So I guess that's me trying to impart it also to my daughter. If there's something that my dad always used to tell us, it would be to always work for the good of the greater number. So I guess that's, again, empathy. And that failure is inevitable, but giving up is unforgivable. So resilience. That's a tough one, I mean. but I guess based on my experience, because I wouldn't want to be a hindrance to, you know, her plans and dreams. I just, you know, whatever. I mean, she could be anything she wants to be, and I'll be rooting for her 100%. As I said, right now she's into fashion and, you know, graphic designing. She's really into Canva. She loves playing with Canva right now. So I guess she'll eventually end up in, you know, in the arts. So yeah, I'll just be there to support her. But also, she's also very comfortable in front of a camera. I mean, with her mom's vlog. So I won't be surprised. To be honest, because Andy's birthday is on the 25th of June. So it's quite close to Father's Day now. So if my memory serves me right, I haven't spent a lot of Father's Days with Ellie, because she's always with her mom. But probably it would be the first Father's Day that we got to spend together. She was about, I think, 4 or 5 years old. And this was back when, you know, no one knew. The public didn't know about it. So it was just me and her. We were here in Manila. I just took her to some hotel and we did her favorite activity back then, which was swimming. And it just felt great that, you know, it was our own moment. Yeah, so that stands out to me. Ellie, thank you for, you know, giving me the privilege of being your dad. I know it's another Father's Day that we can't spend together, but know that I miss you every day, and I love you more than life itself. Can't wait to see you. Because my dad just actually had a bout with COVID-19 last March. So, Dad, happy Father's Day. Thank you for being a great dad, a great provider. I just wish you good health and many more years, because I really hope that you see Ellie grow up and be proud of me as a father too.